All these lights light up the town. When I'm all alone, walking down the street, I want a night.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been really long since I filmed a sit down video, and it feels really really good to actually sit down and talk to you guys. So of late I've been uploading a lot of travel videos. I hope you guys have caught and watched all of those videos. I'm traveling yet again. I'm currently in Vietnam. It's me and my husband here, and we are here for about 7 days. So in this video I thought I will share with you how I take care of my health when I'm traveling. So this video is especially for those people who love to travel but who are also very concerned about their health and they really want to take care of their health. For me, the whole approach to taking care of my health when I'm traveling is always to sort of find that balance. You know, the balance between enjoying the local food and enjoying the local treats, plus at the same time, you know, taking care of your health and sticking to some basic rituals. So this video will have a lot of such information, and I will share with you how I prepared for this trip from India, what are the things that I carried from India, and what are the things that I bought here so that I could take care of my health and my husband's health. So let's get right into the video and let's start right away. The first tip I have for you is that to prepare beforehand. So when you're doing your bookings, make sure that you either book an Airbnb or you book a service apartment which has a kitchen. And the reason for this is that when you have your own kitchen and your own cooking space, it kind of becomes easier to manage your health. Otherwise, you would be eating out all the time. So I'll just give you a quick tour of this place that we are in, and I'm going to show you what are the things that I carried from India and what are the things that I bought here. So this is where we are staying. It's a pretty basic setup. So you have a table here, that's the bedroom. But the part that I really wanted to show you guys is this. So we make sure that, you know, there's some basic kitchen setup in place when we are staying for more than a week. So here you can see that there is an induction top, there's a fridge, and there's a microwave, which is pretty much enough to, you know, take care of your basic food. I've just kept the basic staples which I carried from India. So this is a poha. I made this at home. So this is basically like instant poha. You add hot water and the poha is ready. I'll leave the link for the recipe for this below. I carried some rice with me because some days, you know, it's just nice to have plain rice and curd, and also some dalia, and of course a packet of instant noodles just in case of an emergency. So these are the basic things which I carry from home. Apart from that, what I do is whenever I visit a place, I usually go to the supermarket the first day and stock up on some basics. So I went to the supermarket yesterday and I got milk. I got some yogurt and I also picked up some fruits. So Vietnam is a country where luckily there are a lot of fruits which are very, very easily available. So I got some pineapple and some mangoes. So in this way, it becomes really easy for me to plan both our meals, and depending on my husband's schedule and my schedule for the day, I know that these are the options that are available for me to eat at home, and these are the options that I can go out and eat. So when you have both the options with you, it kind of becomes easier to balance out your meals and to plan your day. The second tip that I try and follow when I'm traveling is to have a really light breakfast. And the reason for this is that breakfast is usually the one meal when you're still in your Airbnb or when you're still in your apartment. So this meal, I try and keep it as light as possible. In breakfast, I usually prefer having a fruit. This is because when you're traveling, you know, you tend to forget to have fruits. So it's good to get one serving of your fruit in first thing in the morning, because then you get all your essential vitamins, minerals, and more importantly, fiber, which is, I think, something that we totally miss out when we are traveling. So what I like doing is having breakfast in the house and keeping it really light by either having fruits or having some yogurt or having milk. So in this way, not only is it easy to prepare, it's healthy, but at the same time I'm making sure that I get at least one serving of fruit into my body. The third tip that I follow when I'm traveling is to stick to my basic routines as much as possible. So the routines that I'm talking about are things like drinking warm water in the morning, taking my supplements, having my apple cider vinegar in the night. I know it's not easy and it's very tempting to just get lazy and to skip all this, but I think that it does make a difference. So I actually carry nimbu and apple cider vinegar from India because I know that if it is available with me, I'm more likely to have it. And if I do not even carry it, there's no chance that I'm going to go out, buy these and, you know, stick to my routine. And that's what even you can do. So you might have different routines. You might have a routine of, you know, say having methi pani in the morning, or you might have some other routine that you follow religiously when you're back home. So when you're traveling as well, try and make that little extra effort to carry your supplements and to carry the things that you need with you, so that you can follow the same routines when you're traveling. The fourth tip that I follow when I'm traveling is a very basic one, but I think this is extremely important, and that is to drink water. Now, obviously, when we are traveling, water is expensive. Most of the times you need to buy water, and we are so busy doing a lot of things that we just forget to drink water. Moreover, most of the hotels or service apartments will give you tiny bottles like this, which are obviously, you know, they don't last long. So you eventually run out of them. So when I'm traveling, what I like to do is that the first day when we are here, like I mentioned, I like visiting the supermarket to stock up on the basics. And I also usually pick up a big keg of water, like a 5-liter or a 6-liter keg of water. This is because of two reasons. Number one is that it is obviously cheaper than buying multiple tiny bottles like this. And of course, you consume less plastic. And the second reason is that once you buy a keg of 5 or 6 liter, it's good enough to last you for at least 2 to 3 days depending on your family size, but it makes sure that you have water available with you so that you see the water, you're reminded to drink water. So like doing is carrying water with me when I am stepping out of the house. So whenever we are out, so obviously when you're traveling, you tend to be out almost the entire day, so I usually carry a backpack with me, and I make sure that I have at least 2 bottles of water filled and kept with me. So just the sheer weight of having that bottles on my back is enough to remind me to continuously sip the water. And the last tip I have for you is about snacking. Now, when you're traveling and you're moving around so much, you tend to get hungry. It's natural. I am all pro for trying the local food and the local cuisine. I love doing that. But I also feel that it's good to come prepared with some of your own snacks from home. So for this trip, for example, I'll just show you the snacks that I prepared and came from India. So guys, these are the snacks that I carried from India. These are basic atta cookies, salted ones. Makhana, this has been made at home. I carry some mixed nuts with me. So in this I have mixed almond and walnut. And I, like you can see, there's an entire packet of this. And I also like carrying chikki because chikki is something which gives you instant energy and it's also fun to eat. So there are 2 types of chikki. And just for emergency, I have a yoga bar. Now, I do not like the taste of yoga bars, to be very honest. And I try not to eat them, but this is just an emergency, you know. Like if there's nothing available at all and we are starving, then we can have yoga bar. And one more very interesting thing, which actually my mom made for me, and which I usually carry when I'm traveling, are these dry fruit laddus. So these are basically laddus made up of dates and mixed nuts. They're extremely healthy, they give you a lot of energy, and they're so simple to carry when you're traveling. So like you saw, these are the snacks that I got from India, and trust me, it wasn't very difficult. All it required was a little bit of planning and a little bit of time, but it made the entire trip so much convenient, right? Because I know that anytime if my husband is hungry, or if we are out the entire day and we do not find anything to eat, especially if you're vegetarians, it can happen that if you're in a country like Vietnam, you know, veg food isn't easily available. So instead of just consuming anything or consuming bad food, it's better that you consume the snacks that you got from home and which are made in your house. So guys, this was a video on how I take care of the health of me and my family when I'm traveling. So in this video, I just shared with you the basic things that I like to do when I'm traveling. And like you, and you must have realized that these are very, very simple, basic things, nothing fancy, nothing complicated about it. And this is something which you too can implement extremely easily. So just to give you a quick summary and a quick recap of what I spoke in this video, basically I mentioned that when you're traveling, plan your travel a little bit better so that you book either a service apartment or an Airbnb where there's a kitchen and a small cooking space easily available for you, so that at least one meal a day if you can have at home, if you want, that is no compulsion. If you feel like having a meal at home, you can do that. The second thing is to carry enough snacks with you so that in case food is not available or good food or good quality food is not available, you're not starving and you do not end up eating anything which is not good for your health. You always have your snacks with you. The third tip is to drink enough water. Make sure that you stock up on water. Please do not rely on tiny bottles like this which are kept in the hotel rooms. They're just not enough. Make sure that you buy a big keg of water with you and keep it with you in the room. The fourth tip is to consume at least one serving of fruit a day, preferably for breakfast, because breakfast is usually the time when you have more control over your meal and you are more likely to be in your apartment. The last one was to maintain simple basic health routines that you follow back home, like drinking lime water, drinking your apple cider vinegar and taking your supplements. So I hope you found this video useful. If you have any more routines or any more tips that you implement when you travel, please share that with me in the comment section below. It would help me out and it would also be good to have a discussion on what more we can do to take care of your health. That's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Please remember to hit the subscribe button. If you haven't done that, give it a thumbs up. And of course, hit the bell icon so that the next time I upload a video, be it on travel, minimalism or productivity, you are notified of that. Alright, signing off for now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.